We have seen this one. But it's very good giant and the sound of the sound has come. Is it visible? Can someone speak unmuting themselves? Is it visible? Can someone unmute and is it visible? Are can
Yes,
okay,
Jack, this
okay.
is visible. Yeah.
So last session we had discussed about this wire we had discussed, and then coming to here, why the or means we discussed, why the and we discussed, but we did not take up this var, how it is used, rand, how it is. But this is linked to wired or logic, and rand is linked to wired and logic. These are something in our STLD or in Lika, there we learned in our engineering. So for this we have seen by going to here, this wired and logic here, that is this one. Wired and how actually this is somebody trying to join again. This problem, to avoid this problem, I requested to join everyone before time, but still happening. Okay, so again I have to go to the presentation. That way distractions are happening. Oh my God. This one here, last session we have seen this one about this internally, how this is there, this portion. So that we discussed here. So if you could able to recollect, this entire thing is a wired AND logic. Similarly, wired OR is possible. This is physically happening. So this how we get that one, that behavior in a Verilog GL is with the help of these constructs. So having seen that, we also have seen last time this supply 0 and supply 1, why they are required. And then we said that next session we'll demonstrate practically through software. So this portion today we'll take up this entire portion here. This one, and this one, and this one. So this portion with a few simulation sort of thing I will do today. So for that, this next, about this next, we know what is net. Net is a data type. This net itself is not a keyword. There is no keyword for net. But this net is a data type. So this data type, we have this wire and try that we have seen last presentation. So this wire, it represents a simple wire doing an interconnection. Only one output is connected to a wire and is driven by that. If you read this line, it represents a simple signal line as wire only it is. Unlike the wire, a tri can be driven by more than one signal outputs. So that is the definition of these two. The difference is this, that you will understand once we go here, that is when we see all these examples. So, wait a moment, where I'm just trying to locate where that, but I think I can't keep that. But last time you see that, let me take this thing. Here we have seen several. Last time we have seen, here is one inverter, and this is connected like this. These are called, such we have seen, here buffer also we have seen one buffer. This one buffer. So in this case, we called them last time, these are sort of tri-state gates. We have called them as the tri-state gates. So state of this here at the output side may be 0, maybe 1, maybe X, maybe Z. These together, if we treat as a one state, and this is one state and this is another state. So we have totally 3 states at the output side. So we have total 3 states at the output side. So that's why such gates are tri-state gate. Actually, we may have as a logic here, either we should have here 0 or 1. But there are scenarios where we have some switch like this. This switch is not connected here. In that case, how do you define this output? The high impedance state. So this high impedance state in the Verilog HDL, we should able to imitate that behavior. This behavior, which is open sort of behavior. It's closed, no issues with that. But if it is open, then that behavior. So there are some cases where your gate is, suppose say you have this one. This is one buffer, and this is another buffer. Oh, sorry, this is only buffer. It's not there. So this buffer, these two are connected to a single output, suppose. Yes, one output. And this is getting some input here, input 1 and input 2. So on what basis this output is decided? So if it is 0, if it is 0, then no issues. This output we can call this as a 0. If this is 1 and if this is 1, then this is no issue. So we can say this is 1. But what if this is 0 and this is 1? Or this is 1, this is 0. So which will dominate? So generally, this one, strength, which has got higher strength, that will dominate. That is the concept of human psychology, which is having some superiority or higher strength, that will prevail. So, but the point is, what I'm trying to make here, the point is, if 0, 0, then no contention problem is not there. If 1, 1, contention problem is not there. If 0, 1 comes and 1, 0 comes, then contention problem will rise. How do we address such a problem? So that's where this, try has come into the picture. So that's where this try has come into the picture. So let us go to this one here so that we can, today we will understand your things about this. So functionally, wire and try are identical. After all, they are driving the nets. That's why they are identical. So a variable, this variable data type we have seen earlier. There are two types of data type. One is a net, the other is a variable data type. So we don't need to go into this variable data type here. Our intention of today's discussion is to understand this try, WAND, and WAR, all that. So straight away we'll go to the contention issues. So strengths and contention resolution. How do we resolve such problem, contention related? In practical situations, outputs of logic gates and signals on nets in a circuit have associated source impedances. This one, source impedance, we have to recollect this one again. That is this slide. In this slide, here if you go, this one, if you see here, that is this particular, this RF. So this is the source that is connected to every this one. This is one gate. If you treat this as a gate, this entire thing here, this is a gate, one gate. So this gate is connected to this impedance here. So likewise, in a practical scenario, some impedances will be there, such impedances. So if such impedances are there, so this, we are talking about that impedance, yeah. So in practical situations, outputs of logic gates and signals on net in a circuit have associated source impedance. This you got the picture, what we are meaning with source impedance. Earlier, just now, a while ago, I had gone to that RF. So that is the source impedance. When the outputs of two gates are joined together, the signal level is decided by the relative magnitudes of the source impedance. This in a paint software, I said, if 0, 0 comes, 1, 1 comes, no issues like that. So that is what here again. When the outputs of two gates are joined together, the signal level is decided, meaning the final output is decided by the relative magnitudes of the source impedances. Who is deciding that output? In fact, the source impedances are playing the role to decide the final output. Sometimes a disparity between the impedances is intentionally introduced to minimize the circuit hardware. In some cases, CAN issues to consider, that is some area network, controlled area network, or some protocol, CAN protocol, wherein each is connected to one single common line here. So such hardware we are talking about here. Sometimes a disparity between the impedances is intentionally introduced. It's wantedly. We don't want to have multiple lines. We want to have only one wire, and which will do the job depending upon some modifications in the sub boxes. I mean, here, not to confuse you here, let me take this. Here we have one common bus, and one device is here, device 1, and device 2, device 3. Such devices are there here. All of the devices are nodes depending upon the subject. So the subject is networks, means we say nodes here. So this is we can connect this one to one separate line, and this second node to separate line, third one to separate line. Likewise, separate we can have 1 to n like that. But the problem having like that 1 to n wire here is not advisable. If we have some mechanism here to handle, some mechanism here, this is some hardware which will actually, this is 1, 2, 3. All are connected through this hardware support. And it is the job of this hardware to understand which one is actually want to put something onto the wire here. Who decides that? This hardware decides. So, and then it will let all are connected to this hardware, like that. So in that case, only we are resolving the problem of having this multiple lines here with the simple hardware. This simple hardware job is arbitrary. It has to look into this 1 to n nodes connected to it, and it has to resolve the problem which one is priority it has to give to the devices among them, which one is higher priority should be given and lowest priority should be given. Such problems this hardware should resolve, and it should successfully put its contents over the bus like that. So that way, what we do, we avoid this multiple lines. So that is what this point is here. is sometimes a disparity between the impedances intentionally introduced to minimize circuit hardware. So that disparity, source impedances disparity, we bring intentionally 1 to n when we connect. That happens, this disparity happens between the among this 1 to n devices, the source impedance, whatever that has been connected, the disparity happens just because we want to minimize the circuit hardware. So effects of such differences in the impedances are indirectly introduced in the design descriptions by assigning strengths to specific signals. This disparity, we want to imitate into the language, something called this terminology, that is strengths. So signal strength declarations are of two types. This strength we are defining, there are two types. Those associated with the outputs of gate primitives and those with nets. So here gates, we have seen our basic AND gate, all that gate level modeling primitives are there, no? They and the nets. So nets here, let me take it. So if I have wire assignment here, I have declared Y as a net here, and I want to assign something to the wire. What I do, assign keyword I use, and then Y, and then here something, suppose say something, just for rough understanding. So I am just performing this AND operation, logical AND operation, and assigning that result to this Y. This Y is a net. Just Y. So this Y is actually coming from having something done here, that is this operation. And there is a net A. A is also a net. A is coming from here. And B is here. So what you are giving A is a signal. This is a logic signal. Logic 1 or 2. Similarly, B also. But how you give this over this net? Over this net. How you give B over this net? How you obtain Y over this net, using this net? So this net we are talking about, this is one scenario. Another scenario, we have gate itself. To this gate we have, this is the net connected, and this is also a net connected. But this gate itself also will have some delay. Inside this gate, we have some, inside gate, what is there actually is transistors, all are bunch of transistors inside gate, all are transistors. These transistors themselves have inherent impedance, some impedance inherently, so that impedance. So this net has some impedance, that is net impedance, this is gate impedance. So also that way, that is what here, this, if you go here, this one here, this point. Signal strength declarations are of two types. Those associated with the outputs of gate primitives and those with nets. So these are, I think this is clear. So we are talking about the signal strength declaration. This strength itself is a disparity, I mean impedances, it is something, some sort of impedances here. In the language, we are calling it as a strength here. There is a link here, I think you are understanding the link here. This impedance, we have in the physical devices impedances, them we are imitating in the language as a strength, and this strength is having two types, that is related to the gate and nets. That's how you have to understand here about this strength. Let's go to this, how in the language we are putting them. In the language we are putting something like this. Extreme left you see supply, and then strong, and then pull, and then B, and then high impedance. So these strengths, I mean impedance, you in your physical, I mean in real life, in a physical devices, you can think of something, this is a having higher maximum impedance, and this is bit low impedance and bit low impedance like that. So, but every stage, every this impedance stage is again subdivided into two, for logic 1 and for logic 0. If logic 1 comes, how it has to handle this impedance. If logic 0 comes, how it has to handle. So at this stage, if you are not understanding, you don't worry, because in subsequent slices, we have the demonstration that will work and will do the simulation. So strength levels associated with outputs of gate primitives in this table 1 gives the names associated with strength, respective abbreviations, and their order of weight. So these hold good for logic 1 state as well as the 0 state, that is logic 0 state. So strength supply is supply has got highest strength, strong has got next, and then full has got next, and then weak, and then high. Them how we are going to use, we'll see here with these examples. You have buff, this is a keyword, this is a buffer, this is a simple gate, that is a simple buffer gate, and this buffer gate has two levels. One is the supply one and the other is the full zero, the other is the supply one. These are here, we have seen here, supply and this full and this full. Since this is abbreviated, SU means actually we have to put supply, full supply. This ST means strong and PU means here the full, and the WE means this weak, and here high means this high, this complete high, high Z1. High Z0, like that. So here what we are doing is, we are just, this is the sentence. Buff is a gate primitive. In the parentheses, we have to put this strength. So we have put the strength here. And as usual, this is simply your buffer has got some input. This is the input. And this is the output. These are the identifiers. So what is that happening here is, when this is zero, so the impedance is tied to zero value. When this is one, and the impedance is tied to one. So you may say, you may get a doubt that if I don't have this two, then also it is happening. I mean, if you give zero, then output definitely will be zero, because after all buffer. And if I give one, then output is one. Because after all buffer gate, then what is the role of this two? Role of this two, you will understand if you see this example. In this example, we are trying to resolve the contention. See, this is one gate, buffer. This gate instantiation name we have given here as a G1. And here we have 0 and I1. See, this OO is the output, this output. I1 is a net, this is the input. Similarly, second gate, that is again the buffer gate, we have here I2, this I2 input, and O, the same O, that is this one. So meaning what? This buffer, actually, there are two buffers, there are two gates, buffer gates. One is G1, the other is G2. And this gate, first gate, that is G1 gate, having an input I1, output is O. This second gate, G2, having an input I2, and the output is O. Meaning what? These two, G1 gate and G2 gate, both are tied to same net, that is O. In that case, how is that these are going to play a role? At that time, there you will understand the importance of this one. For example, in this case, we have this first 00 we are giving input to this. This is the CONT and RES. This is the module here. See this contention resolution for the shortcut. I give anything. This is user defined. But just for reference, this is the contention resolution for shortcut CONTRES. We gave here the name of this module is this. Then that is being instantiated here. First at zero instantiation time, we are giving I1 0, I2 0. When we gave I1 0, you see simulation results. We gave 0 and we gave 0, output is 0 in there. So no contention. But here there is a contention. Contention, the stronger signal prevails. Here, if you don't give this one, that is this supply 1 and pull 0, this strength levels, if you don't give, then there is a problem. We'll do the simulation now shortly. 0, 1 I gave. So what is coming on G1? This is I1, no? I1 means that is G1 gate. So what is I1? I1 is 0. So meaning G1 gate on output O, it is putting this I1. So what is I1? I1 0. So 0 being kept on this O. Now I2. I2 is 1. Since I2 is 1, G2 is again buffer. So on O again we are trying to put 1. So this O net here getting 0, here getting 1. So how we are going to resolve this? We have to resolve because ultimately either it should be a 0 or 1. So we have to resolve this one. We resolve this one using this strength levels. So in this case, what is happening when this is I1, 0, this full 0, that is, are you getting everybody? If you have any doubts, later on you can ask, I will give that time. I1, 0 means, among these two, this impedance will play the role, for only G1 gate I'm talking. So what will come out? 0 will come out, where? On O. But according to this G2, what will come out here? 1 will come out here. 1 will come out. 1 we are giving, 1 will come out. Now here 0 is there, here 1 is there. So this 0 and 1, depending upon these two, we are going to resolve. This language has given the order here. The order is this. Who is having highest priority here? This we have here, what is that we are getting? Supply and pull. There is a supply according to the language, here is the supply. That is the pull. So who is having highest priority? Highest priority is this one. This is the strongest. So here is the highest priority. So this will dominate the net. This will dominate the net. What is there in that? What is there in that? Here, if you see in your code, this supply 1 is there. So meaning one will come as the output. Similarly, 1 0. Same explanation here, 1 0. Now on 1, here you are keeping 1. And here it is, on O you will get 1. On I2 you are keeping 0. I2 you are keeping 0. So since it is a buffer, on O you will have 0. So this time, this G1 gate is having 1 and G2 gate having 0. So the problem contention, this is called contention. This contention problem is resolved with the help of this two. So who will dominate? Whether supply 1 will dominate or pull 0 on the output. So who? This is again decided by this language given priority. Language has given that this will dominate others. So this supply 1 will dominate here and output will be 1. That way, this problem is resolved. When 1 1 comes, there is no contention. So happily, output will be 1. So that's how the contention resolution is. Now, what I do is, instead of demonstrating this slide, I will share with you people. I hope you people have installed at home that Xilinx. So you can work this one. In case any problems, we can discuss. Your code is this. This is your code. You have to remove all this 1 to 5. 1 to 17 you have to remove. This is your code, module to end module. Now what you have to try is, without this you have to try. First of all, without this you have to try. Make a one project. Without the supply 1, pull 0 and this parenthesis, simply you keep this one and run this code. Simulate this test bench. what you get, see, what you get is contention problems will come here. Contention problem means when 0, 1 has come, you see the output here 1. Here you will not see this time 1 because you have removed here this one, supply 1 and pull 0. So it may be X or Z will come here, some unknown or high impedance will come, contention is happening. So here also contention will happen, here 1 will come. After that, what you do, you substitute this parenthesis and supply 1 and 2. Now you see and run the same again code, having saved this file, you run this. This time this problem will be solved here, X or Z, that problem will be solved and you will see the output. That's what we call strength contention. So that's how this is used here. The supply, all these are used at this. Single gate is not going to work. Multiple gates are there, then we can see this, the impact of that, like that. So let us move to this another example. This is another example. In this example, what we are going to do is, we have here, if you see, this is same here, the level is same. I mean, I'll read out problem here. The problem statement is this: consider the example 2, which is slightly modified version of example 1. The gate outputs are decided by following the same logic as in the last case. However, in one case, when both gates drag the output with an equal strength in opposite directions, the output logic level is indeterminate. That is X. So this meaning, equal strength but opposite. If you see here, this gate, this is having one buffer, and the name of this buffer we gave the G1, the instantiation name. We are giving here, these are the, you know, this is the output and this is name. But if you see here, no issues with that. But if you see here, this pull 0 and pull 1, they actually have the same, priority here, this pull. But one is to the logic 1, the other is for the logic 0. So in that case, if you put that context here like that, what is the impact that we are studying in the this example 2? So for example, here in this case, let us see this test bench of example 2. When 0, 0 has come, no contention. It is just like the same example 1 problem. In example 1 also, 0, 0 has come, no contention. But contention came when 0, 1 and 1, 0 has come. Contention came, but the stronger prevails. So that way we resolved, because here we have put supply 1 and pull 0. But in the second case, we are separating for G2. We have put here for G2, the same level here. But one is dragging to the logic 1, the other is dragging to the logic 0. So how these two are fighting each other and unable to resolve, and the contention prevails. See this example here. 0, 1, we give the inputs. We give 0, 1 here. 0 is for I1. So you have given the 0 here. So what is coming out here? 0. So on net O for this gate, G1, output is 0. But coming to here I2, so output is 1. On this, output is 1. So what is now happening here is, because of this 1, and earlier what has come here? 0 has come. So what would have been happened in this case here? If this is having like this, this from different levels, if we would have taken the impedances, then no issues at that time. But because of this, because of So the same level we have taken here. Now the issue is this gate, you see this one, that is the example one. We gave here zero has come over this G1 gate. One we gave, one has come. Now who is deciding this, whether zero or the final overall result? This strength is deciding. On what basis it is deciding? Language has set forth some priority. This one or this one? Which one is having a strongest hold? Strongest hold is for supply one. That's why this one has prevailed here. This one. This zero did not prevail. But in this case...
Hi, Jack. Just one doubt. Can you go previous one? Like supply one and then pull zero. This is what is exactly meaning supply one and then pull zero means? The buffer inputs are like one and zero? This is what you are discussing or what?
No. This strength means strength levels associated with the output gate limits. If you know,
I understand this one. Priority. Priority wise, I understood. Why the gave supply one and then pull zero? That is what I'm not understanding there. Buffer syntax. Yeah.
Okay. This one.
Yeah. Correct.
This one. See. We have the for a while. You don't imagine this here. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now, without imagining these two, if you see, okay. if you are giving zero here, that is the I1 is a zero. What is the value that is there on O?
Output is zero only. This is like a buffer. Output. Like whatever input is there, output will come. Yeah.
This keyword telling that this is a buffer, so output will be zero.
Okay.
Now if you give one here, what is the output here?
One only will come.
Yeah. One. So we have two gates. One is G1 gate, the other is G2 gate.
Okay.
So this gate having a zero and this gate having a one, those two gates are actually letting on the same net zero, on the same net O, we have different values. This is zero and this is one. They two will, there is a contention issue.
Correct. Okay. Yeah.
So this contention language is resolving with the help of this sort of mechanism. So language is resolving that contention issue with the help of this strength levels. So now language has to decide based on this who is having highest priority, because the user has provided this here. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So now the compiler will look into these two, and the compiler will already known that it is known to the compiler that supply one has got the highest priority. So the supply one is here. Here, if you go here, this supply one, so for logic one.
Yeah.
Anywhere in this case, not only supply, anywhere you see 1, 1, 1, 1, this is for logic 1. Anywhere you see this 0, that is for logic 0. And who got the priority? Supply got the priority. So that's why here the compiler in this case, it should make a decision now whether supply 1 be given the priority or pull 0 need to be given the priority.
Okay. Like this is like a one kind of mechanism, whenever we see the contention kind of thing. So that for getting this resolution, this is one kind of mechanism in Verilog. Correct, right?
Yes.
Okay. Exactly. Okay. Thanks. Yeah. Understood.
So now the problem. This is example one. So now coming to the example two, we separated actually this G1 and G2 to focus G1, G2. Both are actually with this strength levels here. But in example two, this G1 strength levels are this two. G2 strength levels are these two. So unlike earlier example, now the problem is when one comes here, that is what we gave in the test bench. Here, this one. Contention between pull 0 due to I1. What is I1? 0. So you have contention between pull 0 due to I1. You go to I1. You see here you get a 0. So these two are there now. Since this is 0, logic 0, this gate, G1 gate, will give logic 0 output based on the strength level associated with this. This strength is for logic 0. This strength is for logic 1. Since single gate, there is no contention issue. Actually, single gate, when single gate comes, there is no contention issue. But here the logic that you have given is 0. So since the logic is given 0, and explicitly you are putting that you treat among these two, this is for logic 0, and for logic 1, this strength level you treat. Explicitly you are telling the compiler for this G1 gate. That's why when 0 comes, since you have dictated to the compiler explicitly that you use for logic 0 this strength level. But default there is some strength level. Default, I will tell you that later on. Default takes compiler will take default strength level, this one. This one, some among this strongest one or strongest 0. Either one will be default. Default strongest will be associated. Meaning, what I mean is, this is not there, suppose. This one not there. If it is not there here, for a while, this G1 gate is not having this 2 in parenthesis what you have kept. Then what is the default here? That supply. That is default. Now, depending upon the logic here, that is 0, then 0 will come. If 1, 1 will come. The default is not seen by the user. It is known to the internally, implicitly. That is what we call implicitly. But explicitly, now we are telling to the compiler, if 0 comes, this strength level you treat. If 1 comes, this strength level you treat. Like that, explicitly for G1, we are telling. So here, if 1 comes, then what is treated? Some strong one will be treated. If 0 comes, what is treated? Full 0 will be treated for G1 gate. So in our example, if we give the 0, now what is that output? The 0 and the strength level is full 0. In this case, come to the another gate, G2. G2 also a buffer only. We have kept a semicolon here, separated. This is another gate, G1. This is another gate, G2. And these G2 strength levels are these two now. If 0 comes, then this strength level. If 1 comes, this strength level. Now in this current example, 1 has come. So 1 has come means what is the strength level associated with G2, this pull 1. So G2 is now having on this O pull 1, and G1 having on output O pull 0 and pull 1. And how is that possible to resolve the contention? Because pull 0 and pull 1 are of same level here. In the compiler, this pull 0, pull 1 are of same level. If different levels, compiler will give the priority to the highest, priority or highest strength. To that, it will give the priority. So that way, contention issue is resolved. But in our example 2, on O we are getting pull 1, G1 we are getting pull 0, and G2 we are getting pull 1. Both levels are same. So again, the contention issue, we cannot resolve this because one side we are trying to tie to the VDD, the other side we are trying to tie to the ground. We are pulling the same point, so same node, pulling towards VDD and also pulling towards the ground. Is that possible physically? Well, it's not possible here. This is something we have to understand, very important, this concept. Well, this is example 2 problem. is example to problem. An example to what I'm trying here is, if you don't mention this here, this strong one, anything within the parenthesis, default it will take some strength level, that is supply, some strongest that it will take, no issues with that. That is called implicit. We don't see user will don't see user simply uses buff and G1 and some input and some output. But explicitly we are writing here strength levels. When zero comes, you assign this full zero. If one comes, you treat this one strength level. That we are telling explicitly to the compiler. With gate G1, what is happening? Since zero has come over this O, full zero is the strength. But here, when one is coming here, what is the strength level available on the O? This full one is available. So on O, ultimately, full one and here, full zero. Both are available on the O net. Meaning what? Same strength with opposite directions here. Full zero and full one. It's nothing but, instead of solving a contention issue, we introduced today a contention issue again. That's why you see the output here, when 0, 1 has come, output is the X, that is contention, unresolved problem. Now, coming to this one here, 1, 0. You see 1, 0. You see 1, 0 in the simulation? This 1, 0. There is no contention. The contention has come only when 0, 1. Why 1, 0 is there? We don't see the contention? That we have to discuss. So remember this time I1 is 1, I2 is 0. So let us go to our code here. This time I1 is 1. 1 means strong 1. And this I2 is 0. 0 means full 0. Obviously on O, what is there now? Strong 1 is there on O because of this G1. Because of this G2, what is there on the O? This I2 is 0, no? Meaning full 0. So now this on O, we have two strength levels. One is a strong one, the other is a full zero. So which is having highest priority? Strong one is having a highest priority. So logic one will be the output. Ultimately, this O will have logic one. That's why this is the logic one. Is that clear to everyone from example one and example two? If that is clear, then the usage of this is clear to you. It means what? The usage of this is clear to you. Are there any doubts? So if what I request is, I will share this one. You, what you have to do is, same thing, you have to try removing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one you have to remove and you have to type in your copy paste, otherwise simply. So like that you can do. So one time what you have to do is, this is since example one, without this explicitly written here, you just remove this one, this within parenthesis what is there, and the same test bench you run, you will see here X, because contention problem will come here. And then you put this one and you will see this output here happy. And the same case here also you can experiment here, this one. With this strength, we have explained what is strength, what is contention, like that. Now we are slowly moving to our WAN and WAR types of NAS. This is actually the thing that we thought of taking up. But straight away going to WAN and WAR is, there is no point without a contention issue. Why? What is contention? What is the strength level? How we solve the contention problem? So without that explanation, this NAND is not having any weightage. Let us quickly go to WAND only, at least we cover WAND at least. Or you can study if I share the slides or somewhere from the any source. Let us go to this WAND. Strengths on NETs can be decided in ways other than a direct declaration also. These offer additional flexibility to the circuit designer. If circuit designer wants to do away with that this problem, this sort of pairing, then he or she can do with this rand and walk. How? Consider the example of figure 3. We'll see the figure 3 here. This rand is a wire declaration which resolves to AND logic in case of contention. This rand is resolving the contention issue with the help of AND logic. This OR is resolving contention issue with the help of OR logic. How this example is seen? This is one example code here. The contention issue, this way we are trying to solve. When I1 equal to 1 and I2 equal to 0, the stronger signal, that is I1, at the that prevails when I1 equal to 0, when I2 equal to 0, both signals being equally strong here, the value 0 is decided according to the AND logic. What is the meaning of this both signals are being equally strong? We'll see with the help of this code. So here we are writing a code module rand. This is user defined. We have inputs I1 and I2, and our output is O. This O output is also declared with a rand keyword again here. Now what we are doing is the same earlier we have put buff and with the some levels and buff. This one we have seen in example 2. In example 2, we have seen this problem, contention problem. So this contention problem took place when I1 was 0. When I1 was 0, when I2 was 1. So your output is X, not decided, because of the contention. What was the contention? The same level here, because of this this one here, 0. This was the full 0 strength on this buff is full 0. And the strength on this G2 was a full 1. But unfortunately, full 0 and full 1 are of same level. That was the that is the thing we are talking about here, somewhere we said. This one. Both signals being equally strong. So the level is same here. Level means, I don't know whether you are getting enough. Level means this one. This one. This is one level. This is one level. In that example too, both are same level, no? One is the logic 1, one is logic 0. Both are fighting because of level same. If level is different, then higher level will prevail. But second example, one is coming a full 0, the other is a full 1. Both are same level. So there is a contention. So that is what I mean, that level means here. Somewhere it is. 0, 1. This one, this contention. Now this contention we are going to solve with the help of rand. This problem we are going to work out with the help of rand. How we are going to work out with the help of rand? This one. This output, again, we declared with a rand. That's it. Here in the earlier case example too, you see the code here. Same code, but contention existed. Contention has come. This contention problem we are solving, this output we are redeclaring with a rand here. Rand, W-A-N-D, rand O. Now what is happening, that contention problem, that is this 0-1 problem, with the help of rand logic we are resolving. This one. 0-1. Now it is becoming a 0. Why? Because contention resolved according to rand declaration. So this rand we have declared, no? The AND logic will work here. Meaning what? On this 0, let us take this 0. I1 is a 0. I1 is a 0. 0 means this full 0. Strength of O is a 0, no? Full 0. This one is what? I2. I2, 1. 1 means this full 1. So on O, what is there? Full 1. So O here having 0, here having full 1. This 0, 1 is resolved with the help of AND logic. AND logic. When for AND gate, if it is 0, 1, what happens? Output is 0, no? So That is what this brand is playing a role. Is that clear? Suresh?
Yes, yes, Jacob. Yeah, it's clear now. This is a brand is like a one kind of like a keyword in Verilla.
Yes, yes, it's a keyword.
Yeah. Okay, understood.
Thank you. So that's how this brand is playing a role and complete the same test bench. This one. Earlier in example to this one, this complete test bench reproduced with the help of this brand here. This brand, again, the same test bench. The only thing here in the output is there is no contention when 0-1 has come. It has come happily 0. This magic happened with the help of this brand. This brand, in fact, we have seen in earlier slides, our earlier discussion here, this one. Physically, these are the things happening. Physical level, at logical level, as a programmer, we don't bother about all this. As a very large programmer, very few will bother about this everything, why this is happening and all everything. So if you see carefully, this is what happened there. This is called wired and nothing but WAND. WAND in the keyword, the Verilla keyword is a WAND. This is physically happening. This physical happening thing in a program, we are able to achieve with the help of that WAND keyword. So with this, I conclude my today's session and later on, we'll cover the war session. Meanwhile, I will share this complete slide here with you people so that you can see that,